to ESPN Plus Big South Men's Basketball. Matt White, Joe Walters here at the Convocation Center. And Joe, this should be a good one here between UNC Asheville and the host Hampton Pirates.
Yeah, Matt, this game should be a good one. Last time we were out, we saw the Pirates split two games between Radford. So, you know, hopefully they've made some improvements. We'll see what they do when they come out offensively. Of course, they have their star, Warren.
Well, and they've got a few guys out here. We've got to take a look at the grad transfer from NC Central and Evan Claiborne, a 6'6" forward who's going to take up a lot of room in the paint for UNC Asheville, as well as a host of other young men here. Talion Jones comes in averaging 20 points a game. Someone that the Pirates have to keep their eye out on this entire game.
Yeah, you started talking about Asheville, and I was over here talking about Davion Warren out of Hampton. He's averaging right now 19.3 points a game. And that he's been coming up big for the Pirates. So we'll look for UNC Asheville to try to contain him somehow. In the last game, he got out to a hot start and cooled off a little bit toward the second half. But, you know, maybe he'll get the Pirates up with another hot start today.
We are just minutes away from tip-off. Coming into today's action, Winthrop, the only undefeated team in conference play, starting off 6-0. Radford, UNC Asheville coming in today, each with one loss in the conference. Hampton, USC Upstate, 3-3, followed by Gardner-Webb, 2-2, Presbyterian, 1-1, and then Campbell High Point, each with three losses in conference play. Longwood, 1-5, and Charleston Southern, 0-4. And we're ready for the tip here. DeJord Dickens and Claiborne, tip one by the Asheville, and we are set and ready to go. Asheville in the road, blue uniforms, white and gray trim. All the way to the basket, pass, turnover. Marquise Godwin will control things here on the opening possession for the Pirates. Warren leads the conference in scoring with 19.3 points per game. 15 seconds showing on the shot clock. Dean looks left, Godwin. 6 seconds on the shot clock. Shelton looks inside, pass tipped and stolen by Asheville. So both teams turn the ball over in their opening possessions. Let's see what Asheville does here on their second opportunity. Jude pump fakes, looks to reset here. Will be Asheville. Asheville comes into today's game looking to get their first win against Hampton. Last year, Hampton swept the series, and the only other previous meeting came back in 2019 where Hampton won 83-64.
And I like what both teams are doing right now as we see another quick turnover by HU. The alley-oop, ooh, nice finish. Both teams are just trying to get it down in the paint right now.
Dean turns it over. Hampton looking to come right back. Shot blocked by Claiborne. Transition opportunity. Jones loses it. Got a whistle and a reaching foul charge to Hampton. It's going to be against Russell Dean, his first, team's first.
Yeah, Matt, like I was saying, both teams are looking to get it down into the paint. And we see right here, quick hands by UNC Asheville leads to the alley-oop dunk. Easy 2 points.
Thorpe receives the entry pass. Claiborne goes one-on-one. Dickens inside out. Key top of the key three. No good. Deuce Dean ahead. Warren in the lane to the bucket. Layup is short. Rebound. Fought for control by Asheville. They lead 2-0 here early on. Jones pump fakes to the bucket and the slam for UNC Asheville.
That's two jams already by UNC Asheville.
4-0. Bulldogs running and slamming early. Godwin comes up and he'll take the three. Shot off the mark, no good. Rebound to the Bulldogs. Bats Jr. will push. Looking to add to the lead here for the Bulldogs. Tajon. Skip past corner. Good rotation here by Asheville, being very patient. Hampton showing man-to-man, bats just inside the free throw line. Jumper's up, no good, and a foul called on Hampton.
Got him on the elbow when he took that jumper. Hampton's come out, they're just looking real lackadaisical, real flat right now. UNC, they just got some energy. They're playing with a lot of energy right now, trying to go ahead and get up, build on this 4-0 lead that they currently have.
50% is Asheville from the floor. 2-4, Batch Jr. Free throw up and good on the season. Just 55% from the free throw line. Thorpe gets a breather. Checking in for him is Trent Stephanie. And there is the average showing through for Batch Jr. missing the second. 3 minutes gone by here in Hampton. Deuce Dean looking inside, had DeJour Dickens for a second. Goes away from the screen. Dean driving. Layup no good. Claiborne with the rebound. Bats up the near sideline. Good ball rotation. Deuce Dean able to poke the ball loose, and the Pirates force the turnover. See if they can get on the scoreboard here. So far, 0-4. Godwin nearly travels with it. Finds Shelton, 17 seconds. Pirates trying to get the offense in motion here. Warren, 6 seconds. Crossover, step back, pull-up jumper is up, and it's good. Davion Warren puts two on the board for Hampton. 5-2, Bulldogs lead here in Hampton.
Don't let Davion warm up. That might just be the beginning. They've been trying to keep him in check so far, but he gets hot, it's over.
Jumper, bats, no good. Godwin will secure the rebound for the Pirates. Warren. Another pull-up jumper, this time from the baseline. Back iron, no good. Bulldogs doing a great job of keeping Hampton off of the boards offensively. And holding Hampton to just 17% shooting from the floor. Claiborne, fadeaway, it's good.
Claiborne is a big body down there for Asheville right now. They're going to have to try to find somebody that can put a body on him and contain him throughout the rest of the game.
Warren goes all the way to the cup. Left-hand layup is good. Davion Warren, all four of Hampton's points. 15-21 and counting. Jones, step back, thought about the three. Stephanie, right elbow jumper, no good. Fast break opportunity for Hampton. Deuce Dean loses control, kick out. Chris Shelton got the defender in the air. Sets up a wide open Marquise Godwin. Three is good.
And a quick 7-0 run has this game back in zeros.
Good ball movement there from Deuce Dean to Shelton to Godwin. Set up the open look. And we're all square here at 7. Jude looks right. Good ball movement here from the Bulldogs. Hampton's sticking with the man-to-man. Bulldogs shooting 43% from the floor. Skip pass to the corner. Three from Batts is up, and he'll answer. Batts, only a 13% three-point shooter. Pirates will live without three from Batts. And an offensive foul will take us to the media timeout. Davion Warren steps in and gets the foul on Batts. That'll take us to the media timeout. You're watching ESPN Plus.
All right, let's go to this family reunion.
Go Rogue in the all-new, fiercely reimagined Nissan Rogue.
We're back here on ESPN Plus, and it's been Asheville early on, jumping out to a 7-0 run. You see Claiborne with the easy alley-oop slam, and then Jones getting in the lane for the flush of his own. And UNC Asheville taking advantage of some Hampton mistakes early on. And you see Batts here. He broke the 7-7 tie. You know, as you said earlier, Joe, it's been a game of runs. Asheville jumped out 7-0. Hampton answered with their own. But that three from Batts gives the Bulldogs this three-point advantage.
Yeah, and Davion Warren's been big for the Pirates. In the last two or three minutes or so. He's got all their points right now. So You know, they're going to be looking to get the ball back into his hands as we move throughout this half.
We reached the 14-minute mark. Shaheem Anthony checks back into the game. He's going to work. Pull-up jumper in the lane. Back iron, no good. Thorpe will secure the rebound. Judd finds Battle. Jones catch and shoot. His three is good. Tajon Jones, the redshirt junior out of Oak Ridge, Tennessee.
Both teams shooting at 50% from the three-point line right now.
Warren has some success. He'll take the three off the mark. Rebound Bulldogs. Again, Bulldogs dominating the rebounds. Have kept the Pirates off the offensive boards at all. And the layup there from Judd is up and good.
And that was just bad defense by the Pirates. Somebody wasn't paying attention.
15-7.
Like a blown defensive assignment.
It's been a game of runs. 8-0 run for the Bulldogs. Godwin in the lane. Tough layup, and it's good. Marquise Godwin now with 5 points. Leads the team in scoring here thus far. Jones catching, shooting again. Back iron, no good. Offensive board comes back to UNC Asheville. They will reset here. 16 seconds showing on the shot clock. Thorpe in the lane. They're going to call a foul on Marquise Godwin. His first.
Now, remember back in the day when that would have just been a turnover? They wouldn't have called that a foul in the 80s. No way they call that a foul in the 80s.
Tough call on Godwin. 12 and a half to go. It will be Bulldogs basketball here on the inbound. Battle will drive on Godwin. And that will be a travel on Battle. It will be Hampton basketball. Godwin thought he picked up his second one within seconds of.
He wasn't careful. He could have picked up his second one.
Full court pressure from UNC Asheville right now. They're controlling the tempo, shooting 6 of 11 for 55% from the floor. Hampton 4 of 12 for 33%. 15 seconds. Double screen for Deuce Dean. Goes with the left-hand layup and gets the roll.
Deuce Dean coming up big on the offensive end right now. He had a great game not too long ago, so they'll be looking to get him involved in this offense as well today.
Bulldogs lead is 4. Stephanie, top of the key. Dribble handoff here. We'll wind up with Thorpe. He'll take the pull-up jumper. Three is no good. Tip back to Battle. Battle layup is good. Good second chance effort there for Asheville. Battle able to secure the rebound and the second chance opportunity. Dean back in the lane again. Lost control. Shelton catching, shooting his three. Left corner, no good. And another strong rebound for Asheville. That was Lawson. Thorpe trying to back down. Davion Warren tips it away. Turnover. Strong move from Warren. Layup is good and one. Davion Warren doing it on both sides of the floor. Got the steal and drew the contact on the layup. That'll take us to the media timeout. You're watching ESPN Plus. Yeah, I am what I am. I don't have no time for no misunderstandings again. Back here on ESPN Plus, take another look at it. Davion Warren forces the turnover, drew the foul, and when we come back, he'll be at the free throw line. That last foul was charged to Luke Lawson, his first. Second team foul on the Bulldogs.
He's doing it all on the offensive end right now for the Pirates.
This year, Warren shooting 76% from the free throw line. And to your point, Joe, all the scoring for Hampton has come from Davion Warren, Marquise Godwin, and chip in one layup there from Deuce Dean. Free throw from Warren. Off the mark, no good. Speaking of Deuce Dean, he's getting a breather. Bryce Earl, the sophomore out of Columbia, South Carolina, will check in for him. 11 minutes remaining in the first half. Bulldogs lead is 4. Lawson cut through the middle of the defense. Left a wide open layup. Couldn't knock it down. Warren in the lane. Euro step. Contact, no call. Rebound controlled by the Bulldogs. And Stephanie in the lane. His layup is going to be short, but I think he got his own tip. And Stephanie finishes the fast break for the Bulldogs. 19-13, full court pressure here from UNC Asheville. Bryson Godwin worked the backcourt. 20 seconds for the Pirates as they cross the timeline. Godwin going to put it on the floor, and they're going to say he stepped out of bounds.
That looked like a force out. I don't believe the ref didn't call that, but that was a foul and a forced out just now. Should be Pirates ball.
Dejure Dickens and Deuce Dean replace Shelton and Earl.
You know, Matt, what I do like about UNC Asheville right now, they're really coming down and taking advantage of all the opportunities that they're given. They're running their offense, not being scared. When there's a fast break, they get into the paint, they're scoring, drawing fouls. They're doing what they need to do.
Jumper is up and good.
See, right on cue. I talk about them taking advantage.
Second made three for Jones, and another turnover for Hampton. 22-13, the score right now. Asheville out-rebounding Hampton 14-6.
Three offensive rebounds to Hampton, zero right now. Those can prove to come back and bite them in the toward the end of the game if this turns out to be a close one.
We got a 30-second timeout call by Hampton. Let's take a look at some scores around the rest of the conference. Winthrop in earlier action today. Remains undefeated, 10-0 in the season, 7-0 in conference play. Knocked off Gardner-Webb, 75-65. Coming up at 5 o'clock, Radford will be in Charleston, South Carolina at the Buccaneer Fieldhouse, taking on Charleston Southern. 6 p.m., Campbell will be in Farmville, Virginia at Willard Hall, taking on Longwood. So that's your outlook today. For Big South men's basketball, those games can be watched on ESPN Plus. And Winthrop and Gardner-Webb will also have their second matchup tomorrow, also broadcast on ESPN Plus. Under 10 remaining in the half. It's a 9-point advantage for UNC Asheville. Jones cut off, finds Battle, 13 seconds on the shot clock. Pirates gonna try and get a stop here. Batch Jr. works the baseline. They're going to say he stepped out of bounds. And it's turnover number 6 for Asheville. Right now, Pirates looking at a full court press from the Bulldogs. They get it into Warren, and they'll clear. 22-13 is our score here in Hampton. Warren will find Bannister as the Pirates will initiate their offense. 16 seconds showing. Dean tried to get it into Dejure Dickens, but Batch read the play. Jones catching, shooting his three. In and out, no good. Claiborne, who just checked back in. Offensive rebound. Batch will take the three. No good. Not a good shot. Batch was wide open, but statistically speaking, under a 20% three-point shooter, excuse me.
I can't imagine that Coach Morrell was happy about that shot.
Comes to Chris Shelton, and he gets on the board for the first time for the Pirates. Battle. Thought he had a lane. Runs right into Dejure Dickens. Kick out Thorpe. His three's up. Air ball. Rebound. Hampton. Davion Warren working on the bigger defender, and Claiborne will reset. seconds showing on the shot clock. Pirates trail 22-15. Warren has the bigger defender on him. Step back, pull up jumper off the mark. Bannister offensive rebound, and it's good.
Nice strong play by Bannister, grabbing that and putting it back up for the Pirates.
Right place, right time for the sophomore out of Chesapeake. Jones comes off the screen, gets another one, playing a two-man game with Claiborne. They're going to lob it up. Dickens was stuck midway. He realized he was not going to be able to get that block in time, but it was too late. Goaltending is the call.
He was trying to prevent another alley-oop. He said, not two times.
So,
not two times.
Credit
today.
Those 2 points to Tate Jones. To Tate John Jones, excuse me. Not sure what the delay is, but the official was talking to the crew at the scores table.
I guess they might be trying to figure out who to credit those points to.
And Marquise Godwin will check back in. He'll replace Shelton. Deuce Dean gets it into Warren. Godwin finds Dean. 16 seconds as Pirates look to set up the offense. Dean throws it back. Bannister, 8 seconds. Warren getting hounded, gets in the lane. Marquise Godwin, open three, right side, and it's good. Two made threes for Marquise Godwin, and the Pirates find themselves trailing by four.
UNC Asheville just a little over-aggressive on that defensive
three
series.
From Judd, no good. Nearing the 7 minute mark, Hampton trying to will them way back.
This game stays true to how it started off. We're about to see Hampton go on a run.
10 seconds. Screen and roll opportunity here for Warren. Gets in the lane, goes up, contact, no call,
very
but the
nice.
Layup is good.
That was an and one. Davion Warren showed him who the boss was, taking it down there like that, man.
Warren with his fourth field goal today brings it to a 2-point differential. Judd finds Claiborne on the cut, and he will throw it through with authority. Evan Claiborne.
That's a big boy down there. Claiborne is a big boy. 6'6", 228. Who's getting under the rim to stop him? Nobody.
Godwin finds Dean with 18 seconds showing on the shot clock. Goes away from the screen, sets up Godwin, catching, shooting another three, but a whistle and a foul, and they're going to get Claiborne on fouling the shooter.
They found the mismatch with between Claiborne and Godwin. So.
And that'll take us to the media timeout. Asheville up four. You're watching ESPN Plus.
His first, team third, media timeout.
Everybody here, get it out of control.
Born the grad transfer from Dayton, Ohio, showing his authority down low. But unfortunately, he was a little too intense on the defensive end, Joe, and he fouled Marquise Godwin in the act of shooting a three. Yeah. So Godwin now at the free throw line.
Hampton's going to have to find a body that's big enough to contain Claiborne down on this offensive end for UNC Asheville.
First free throw is good. Second one is good. And the third shot from Marquise Godwin is good. So, again, the Pirates find themselves trailing by one, showing zone now. Asheville will work the ball left to right. Bats trying to find somewhere to go. Stephanie, 12 seconds. Free throw line, battle finds Bats Jr. Ball goes out of bounds. They'll say it will remain with Asheville as Mason, the freshman out of Greensboro, came in there and tried to secure the rebound, but it will stick with the Bulldogs as Jones will replace Mason. So good effort by the freshman, helping his team maintain the possession. Under six to go. Stephanie driving. Jude comes away. Three, off the mark, no good. Two Pirates will fight for it. Davion Warren will somehow come away with it. And the Pirates could take the lead with the field goal here.
They slow it down and try to get into some sort of offensive set. They haven't really been able to do too much of that in the early going, but
and there you go. Warren finds DeJour Dickens for the slam, and the Pirates take the one-point advantage, 27-26. Pirates now shooting 50%, 11 of 22. After a slow start, Pirates starting to find some offense. Battle shot, no good. Dean will push for Hampton. Leading by one as we reach the five-minute mark. Dean uses a left hand. Shot is short. Rebound Jones.
I thought Dean was going to try and go for that alley-oop. He saw he had Dickens on the weak side. Wide open.
Ball swung around the perimeter by the Bulldogs. 16 seconds on the shot clock. Stephanie, nice move through the defense. Got the roll off the back iron, and it's good.
It's pretty.
Very pretty
and
move.
And a quick turnover by the Pirates again, man. Stephanie had a beautiful move.
And it looked like it was a miscommunication there by Hampton on the inbounds. It would have resulted in a turnover possession to the Bulldogs. Saheem Anthony will return to the floor. He'll replace DeJour Dickens.
At this point, Hampton's just committing a lot of mental mistakes. And they're mentally erroring at the moment.
16 seconds on the shot clock for the Bulldogs. Throat goes down low. Jude pump fakes, and the layup is good. Corey Jude with his second field goal. Lead up to three again for UNC Asheville. Warren looks to work the screen. Anthony, fall away jumper for Warren is good.
Nice little fadeaway shot.
That's Battle in the lane. Layup no good. Rebound comes to Bannister. Dean has a mismatch. Has Jude on him. Gets into the lane. Goes with the right hand. Layup won't fall for him. He was looking for the foul. Didn't get the whistle. Asheville maintains a one-point lead. Throat cuts through the lane. Jones, right corner this time, is three. Up, no good. Battle offensive board. His layup will fall.
Asheville's just playing like they want it more right now.
Jamon Battle, the sophomore out of Richmond, Virginia, with the putback extensively back to three for the Bulldogs. Anthony will take the three. Far right corner, no good. Rebound to Battle. Stephanie doesn't have the number, so he will hold. Battle, one-on-one with Daniel Bannister, cutting throw up and under, and a whistle and a foul called on the Pirates. It's going to be called on Saheem Anthony.
They're going to have some difficult choices to make.
PM Plus, where Davion Warren has led the charge for Hampton, down by as many as seven. Hampton led briefly. It came on that pass on the screen and roll to DeJour Dickens, Joe. And you've seen Hampton find ways to score between Deuce Dean, Davion Warren, and others. But right now, Asheville will be at the free throw line. Will be Thorpe.
Hampton's been scrapping, Matt. They've been scrapping. I mean, the offensive sets, they haven't really been able to get into them because of, you know, turnovers and mental errors. But, you know, once they've been able to settle down and get into some things, they've been able to put some points on the board, and that's what has them down by three right now.
Free throws coming from L.J. Thorpe, Richard Jr. out of West Palm Beach, Florida. He's a 58% free throw shooter. Knocked down the first. Short on the second. Rebound, Davion Warren. 3 minutes remaining. Hampton trails by four. Godwin looking for Warren. They're trapping on the sideline as Asheville skip to a wide open Deuce Dean. Bannister on the cut. He's tripped and the layup is good.
Nice and one by Bannister.
Sometimes it's better to be lucky than good. Danny Bannister made a great cut.
Right place, right time.
Inadvertent trip, of course, there by the defense, but I bet you if Danny Bannister tried to make that layup the rest of his life, it wouldn't go in. Take another look at it here. Good ball rotation. And
that was a nice find by Deuce Dean.
Nice find by Deuce Dean. And the free throw from Bannister is good. And Bannister shooting about 68% this year from the free throw line. He'll get a breather. DeJour Dickens will come back onto the floor. It's a one-point ball game here in Hampton as we are 2.5 away from halftime. Jones, three, no good, but he's fouled. And he'll head to the free throw line to shoot three.
Shelton, foul on Shelton.
It looks like it was Shelton. Did not give Jones enough space to come down. Chris Shelton. Picking up his first.
That's another one of the mental mistakes that I was talking about earlier, Matt. When you got a guy out, you know he's been shooting threes all game. He hasn't really been hitting them a whole lot. There's no sense in going out there and picking up a foul and allowing three free throws. You got UNC Asheville. They're only shooting 21% from out there. So, you know, I know as a player, he's probably not thinking about that, but those are things that you got to recognize when you're on the floor.
Jones with two made threes today. 12 points right here. Could be 13 with the third free throw. He gets all three. Lead goes back to four for the Bulldogs. 2.5 minutes to go. Picking up full court press. Davion Warren had to work to get open, and he'll bring the ball across the floor. Dean will look over the defense. Man-to-man look this possession from Asheville. Dickens was open on the roll, and he was fouled immediately. It looks like that was going to be charged to LeVar Battle. That'll be his second, team sixth.
Dickens was slashing to the hole. He was looking for blood. Had that gone up for him?
Dickens not in the act of shooting, so baseline out of bound, and it will be none of the officials can make a decision, so it's a jump ball. Possession error belongs to Hampton. Pirates look to inbound, get it into Dickens. Pass stolen by Stephanie. Stephanie going the other way. Layup is up and no good. Marquise Godwin will secure the rebound. And dang. Stephanie can't believe he just blew a wide open layup like that after he did a great job in getting the steal. Davion Warren, right corner three, is an air ball. Jones secures the rebound for the Bulldogs. Bats drops it off. Claiborne. With the dunk.
Power moves. The Pirates don't have anybody that can bang with him down there right now.
So 5-point advantage, 90 seconds remaining. Coach Joyner will call a 30-second timeout.
I think he wanted to give Warren some rest for that eye. He got poked in his eye.
So it was a timeout to get Bannister in for Warren, who apparently got poked in the eye on that last possession. Hopefully Warren will be able to return as he walks off the floor. Dean gets in the lane, layup up, no good, too strong, but they're going to call a whistle and a foul. Let's see who they call it on. I'm going to say on Bats Jr., that's his third. Excuse me, that's his second.
I like that Dean is getting to the basket and trying to use that left hand to go up. He needs to do more of that. He plans to bring his Pirates back into this game and retake the lead.
16 foul on Asheville. Godwin comes open on the inbounds three. Is good. Catch and shoot for Marquise Godwin. That's his third made three today.
Godwin's been on fire from behind the three. He's shooting 57% today.
One minute remaining in this contest. Thorpe in the lane. Got the defender in the air. And let's see what the call is. They're going to say count the basket foul on Dickens. One shot.
That was a pretty stop and go to get his defender in the air and blow right by him. Man.
Second foul on Dejore Dickens. 16 foul. Checking in for him will be number 32, Najee Thomas. Freshman out of Fayetteville, North Carolina. Free throw for throat is good. He converts the three-point play. 52 seconds. Godwin will bring the ball across midcourt. Going to the bucket. Layup is blocked. Goes out of bounds. Will remain Asheville basketball. Excuse me, Hampton basketball. Last touch by Asheville. 18 seconds on the shot clock.
I like that Godwin was being aggressive right there, trying to get to the rack, but he should have pulled back out and tried to reset that offense.
18 seconds on the shot clock, 40.8 on the game clock. Godwin will throw it in, finds Dean. Dean all the way to the cup. Hesitates. Cutting Shelton. Layup is up and good.
Beautiful find. Bruce Dean with a beautiful find.
And we got a whistle and a timeout call by Asheville. A 5-point ball game here in Hampton. 27.1 seconds left. Right now, both teams hovering around 47% as we take a look at some highlights. UNC Asheville 16 of 34 for 47.1. Hampton is 15 of 32 for 46.9. Asheville 3 of 14 from 3. Hampton 2 of 8. Very close game right now. Difference really coming down to just taking care of the basketball. Both teams almost even in turnovers, 6 to Asheville, 7 to Hampton. So we come out of the timeout. So 1.1 second differential between the game and the shot clock. Both teams sitting with six team fouls. So the next foul would put either team at the free throw line for the 1-1. So you would assume, and as it looks here, Joe, Asheville will hold for this last shot.
As they should. Smart.
Stephanie makes a move here at 10 seconds. Stephanie in the lane. Goes back. Juke catching, shooting his three is up. In and out. No good. Thorpe put back is good at the buzzer. And that will take us to halftime with Asheville leading 43-36. You're watching ESPN Plus. We'll be back with the second half.
Asheville 43, Hampton 36.
After season, ace your immune support with Centrum.
Us, Matt White, Joseph Walters here in Hampton, where the Bulldogs of UNC Asheville lead the Hampton Pirates 43-36, and it will be Bulldog basketball to start the second half. And the Bulldogs really imposing their will in that first half, Joe.
Yeah, I mean, they had nothing for Claiborne down in the paint. He's been taking advantage of a lot of easy buckets, getting dunks at will, it seems. So, you know, there was a lot of mental errors by the Pirates in that first half. We'll see if they clean it up in the second half and see what they can do to kind of calm down Claiborne.
Thorpe's jumper long, no good. Warren looks over the defense, down low, pass to Dickens, tipped away and stolen by the Bulldogs.
Pirates.
Thorpe again goes through the lane.
Ooh, that was nice. That was nice.
Took advantage of the transition defense. Hampton didn't stop the ball, and the lead now for UNC Asheville is up to 9.
Thorpe good hands. He almost lost that one. He was able to put it together at the last minute.
Deuce Dean gets into the lane, looking for somewhere to go with the ball. Has worn 10 seconds now on the shot clock for Hampton.
Going back, talking about Claiborne, he's a stop Deuce from coming into the hole again.
Warren pulls up from the elbow.
Doesn't matter, though. Davion about to put his cape on, trying to see if, what he can do to bring these Pirates back.
Warren now with 12. Leading scorer for Hampton is Godwin with 13. Claiborne spinning. Pump fake. 16 seconds comes to Jude. His three is good.
Ooh, that was
Cody well Jude.
Well beyond the three.
Knocks down his first three of the game. Pushes the Bulldog lead now to double figures for the first time at 10. Shelton looking inside for Dickens. Dickens pass. Warren being held in the layup. No good. Nearly a three-point play. But Warren will head to the free throw line. The foul is on Tajon Jones.
There was nothing Tajon could do just now. You gotta wrap your guy up when he gets by you that bad.
It's gonna be his first, team's first.
Asheville foul on number 3, Tajon Jones, his first, team first.
Warren at the free throw line to shoot 2. First shot is short. One more shot for Davion Warren, the league leader in scoring here in the Big South at just over 19 points per game. Makes the second. Deuce Dean nearly comes away with the steal. Pirates on their own full court pressure, showing a 2-2-1.
We saw Asheville play that whole first half. It seemed like full court pressure for the Pirates.
Thorpe will inbound. Bats in the lane. Wild, but was somehow able to create that layup opportunity. Godwin. He'll take the open three in transition, and it's good. Fourth made three for Godwin. Lead back to single digits at 8.
3 quick points.
Thorpe, 12 seconds. Screen from Claiborne. Works the baseline. Shot, I think that might have been blocked. And he stepped out of bounds to Tajon Jones. And it's a turnover. Possession goes to Hampton.
And we're seeing HU get a couple lucky breaks right now, along with some good defense.
Godwin right now with 16 points. Trying to find somewhere to go with the ball. Defense falls back, takes a long three. Shot no good. Thorpe will push. Jones, corner, works the baseline. All the way to the basket. Pump fake. Dumps it off Claiborne. Claiborne pump fakes and he slams it again.
He is catching them. He is catching the Pirates with the pump fake every time, man. Nobody wants to put a body on him right now.
Be back to 10 for the Bulldogs. And the Pirates try their own alley-oop pass too high for DeJore Dickens. Jones layup is up and good.
Man, they're getting fancy with it now, man. Asheville trying to lay it on thick.
Lead is 12. That'll take us to the media timeout. You're watching ESPN Plus.
30-second timeout for Hampton turns into a media timeout.
The doctor said I had...
The trail takes you. We have the selection, value, and strength to get you there. Hercules Tires. Ride on our strength.
Back here at the Hampton Convocation Center, where it's been the Bulldogs here early on. Lead up to 12 now at 54-42. Pirates is making mistakes, and credit the Bulldogs are taking advantage. So full court press here for the Bulldogs. Dean going to throw it in to Warren. 16:20 remaining. So far, 11-6 is the run here in the second half for Asheville. 12 seconds. Hampton tried to get Bannister going back door. Turnover. Battle is fouled on the layup, and he'll to the free throw line to shoot two. And that'll take us to the media timeout. 54-42, you're watching ESPN Plus. Back here on ESPN Plus, Matt White, Joseph Walters here, as it has been a bit of a slow start here for Hampton, but Marquise Godwin has found some luck here today, has found his stroke, leading his team in scoring with 16.
He's going to be looking to get Godwin more involved in the game. As the stretch comes down to the close, Battle standing at the free throw line, shooting two.
First free throw for Battle is good this season. Number one, Jamon Battle, 59% coming into today, 10-17. Splits the pair here. It's 13-point advantage for the Bulldogs. Asheville showing man-to-man here, and another turnover for Hampton as a miscommunication between Bannister and Warren results in a turnover. Checking in for UNC Asheville will be number 22 in G. He'll replace Claiborne. And Chris Shelton will return to the floor and will replace Bannister. Seconds on the shot clock. Bats comes off the screen. Pick and pop with good defense there for Hampton. Waiting on Jude to receive that pass. Stephanie looking to create in the lane. 6 seconds. Floater up. No good, but there's going to be a foul on Hampton. Going to be on Warren.
See right there. It's a touch foul. Still a foul.
Yeah, it was a tough call. Entry pass comes in to Battle. Battle working on the 7-footer. Shot is blocked. Comes out to Warren. Warren with one defender in front of him. Euro step goes with the floater, and Davion Warren puts two more on the board. 11-point advantage for Asheville. Jones receives the pass, goes with the right hand, high off the glass, no good. Rebound initially controlled by Hampton, but it looked like Battle might have got a hand in there and knocked it off Dickens, and it will be Bulldogs basketball.
Dickens with that height, he's got to go up there and grab that rebound and secure it. He can't let anybody come down and pluck the ball out of his hands and make him go out of bounds like that.
Stephanie driving, looking for somewhere to go, throws it away. Thought Mason was going to be in the wing.
He was trying to pass it to his coach, Matt. He was trying to pass the coach.
I highly doubt that. And it looks like Thorpe will check back in. Oh, never mind. Thorpe was headed to the bench. But Coach Morrell quickly stopped that substitution from happening. Deuce Dean across the timeline. Pirates trail by double figures as we reach the 14:36 mark. Warren, again in the lane. Step back, jumper's gonna be short. Jude, trailer, they're gonna call Stephanie for an illegal screen. And now Thorpe will come in, he'll replace Jones. First foul on Stephanie, second team foul on Asheville.
Jones, they're leading the score right now, so we'll see if UNC Asheville will be able to continue to pretty much score at will with him sitting on the bench.
Motion here for the Pirates. Deuce Dean goes to the basket. Godwin catching, shooting another three, no good. Rebound, Bulldogs. Thorpe uses the pivot, trying to find somewhere to go. Skip, Jude catching, shooting, tough shot. It's gonna be short. Mason comes over the back of Godwin, so it will be Hampton basketball on the out of bounds.
I can't see how they didn't call that over the back, but they've been calling some other very questionable fouls.
Godwin will bring the ball across the floor. Skip pass. Now ahead to Dickens. Dickens for the easy slam. Good ball movement there for Hampton. Breaking the press results in the seven-footer getting the easy dunk. Warren, a steal.
Quick hands.
Marquise Godwin will slow it down. Hampton will look to get it back down low to Dickens. Dickens puts it on the floor. Floater is good. Back-to-back buckets for Dejor Dickens, and Hampton finds himself trailing 55-48.
Dickens taking advantage of the smaller Jude.
And we've got a timeout called here by Asheville, wanting to stop the Pirates' momentum.
Wouldn't be surprised if we saw Claiborne come back in the game right now.
Yeah, right now we're back to where we were at halftime, Joe. Both teams having scored 12 points here in this second half. It's a 55-48 score, 7-point advantage for UNC Asheville. And Dickens with those last 4 points, give him 6 for the game. Has pulled Hampton back to a 7-point deficit, and credit Davion Warren's quick hands, his second steal of the game leads to that fast break opportunity. So let's see if Hampton can continue to ride this wave of momentum, or will Asheville able to push and impose their own tempo. We saw here earlier, Warren coming away with the steal, got the floater to fall. And then just a few minutes ago, Warren finds Dejor Dickens for the slam.
Big plays for the Pirates right now.
And then we saw this just a few moments ago, Dejor Dickens with the back down and the floater. So it's a 7-point advantage as we return to live action here in the Convocation Center. Bass going to look to create here for Claiborne. 13 minutes in the ball game. Bass looks to create. Claiborne spinning in the lane. Try to throw a no-look pass. He had a dunk if he would have just turned to the basket. He'll drop step again. Shot no good. Rebound control by Hampton. Warren had the ball picked from behind. Claiborne able to get it back, if you will. Bats Jr. jump stopping, and they're going to call a jump ball. Good hands by Deuce Dean. It's Hampton ball on the possession arrow.
Those great hands by Deuce Dean. Every possession counts right now for the Pirates.
Asheville will fall back into their half court defense. Godwin thought about it. See if the Pirates can get Chris Schultz going. He's got 4 points on 2-of-2 shooting, but credit the Bulldogs. If they came in here to take him out of the game, they've done that, and they call a travel on Warren on his drive to the bucket. I think he took one too many steps, but it was an aggressive move to get to the cup. 12:22 to go.
See, they brought Jones back in the game. They've been kind of flat. Asheville has.
Trey Bourne works the baseline. Goes straight up through Dickens. Dickens' arm straight up, able to deflect the ball. Good defense there.
And it's that height. The height of Dickens right now is affecting Claiborne's play.
And Davion Warren drills another three-pointer. Four-point ball game here in Hampton. Can Asheville answer? Claiborne sets the screen. Thorpe had the ball knocked loose. Steps over the defender. Tough break on, I think, Shelton, who fell down and then trying to get up. Tripped the Bulldog, and that will take us to the media timeout. It's a four-point ball game in Hampton. You're watching ESPN Plus. Back here on ESPN Plus, Davion Warren helping to lead the charge for Hampton to get back into this ball game. Right now, it's a four-point ball game as Asheville is at the free throw line. It's four. 58% free throw shooter. He's 2 for 3 today. Makes the first. Push it back to 5. One more shot on the way for the Richard Jr. out of West Palm Beach. He makes them both. Lead goes back to 6 for the Bulldogs. 3 players in double figures for Asheville. Hampton right now with just 2. Foul on Jude.
Asheville foul number 22, Cody Jude.
That's his first third team foul. Shelton comes open on the inbounds, catching, shooting, back iron, no good. Bats will push up the far sideline, spinning in the lane, nearly traveled with it. Jones, floater, off the mark, no good. Chris Shelton will secure the rebound. Hampton still trailing by 6. Dean in the lane to the basket with the left hand. No call. Bats throws to Jude, deflected by Dickens. And Asheville going to slow things down here and reset with 20 seconds. Jones, three-pointer, no good. Hampton will cross the timeline here at 10:48.
Deuce Dean's got to realize that his shots are not dropping right now. So
yeah,
he needs to create some contact and at least try and get to the free throw line.
Marquis Godwin's 3, no good. Yeah, as you said, Dean shooting 14.3% from the floor. That's 1 of 7. With that miss, Godwin now 5 of 11, 3 for 6 from 3. Jones finds Claiborne all the way in the corner. Claiborne trying to use the move, nowhere to go. Good defense by Dickens. 5 seconds. Thorpe goes in the lane. Fall away jumper hits the side of the backboard. No good. Davion Warren, quick outlet with one defender in front of him. Layup up and good in traffic.
Beautiful control by Davion just now in that layup.
It's a four-point ball game again. Jones thought about the 3. Drives to the basket. Lives it off for Claiborne. And Claiborne dunks it home.
Claiborne's trying to bring the rim down every time he goes up, man.
Back to a 6-point advantage for the Bulldogs. Godwin gets into the lane. Goes all the way to the cup, and the layup is good. Was able to beat the defender.
Well, there's a miscommunication on defense by the Bulldogs, but
I think Claiborne underestimated the speed of Godwin. Back to a 4-point advantage. 9.5 to go. Pirates showing man-to-man here. Battle to Claiborne, top of the key. Bats pull up, left elbow jumper off the mark, no good. Rebound Warren. Pirates can cut it to a two-point ball game here. Warren, quick pull-up elbow, a free throw, jumper, it's good. Davion Warren filling up the stat sheet. Give him 22, 10 of 17, and we've got a two-point ball game.
I don't know if everybody heard that scream he let out after he knocked down that three, but anybody that's a baller knows that when somebody starts yelling and screaming on the court, they're ready to start going off, and we're seeing that from Davion right now.
Dean nearly comes away with the steal. Jones fouled.
No, that was a foul.
Deuce.
He can't even be mad.
Deuce Dean trying to recover as Bats nearly lost, and Marquise went for the basketball. Dean tried to recover, and Jones took advantage of that opening, and Dean hit him on the arm. So Jones back to the free throw line.
It's another one of those times where you just got to know, hey, we're fouling three-point shooters that currently are shooting 22% from beyond the arc. So you could have let that one fly. If he knocks it down, so be it. Get back and play some defense. But the stats are showing.
First free throw, no good for Jones. Remains a two-point ball game. Take another look at it here. You see.
Yep, no contact right on the wrist.
Second free throw is good.
Tajon scored a season high 29 points against Radford last season. So he's leading his team. Eighth 20-point performance this season.
Warren.
He's coming up on that right now.
Has the ball. Pirates down 4, 8.5 to go. Penetrates, pull up, short, gets his own rebound, put back, long, no good. Bannister got the offensive rebound. His second chance, no good. Good defense there by Asheville, never giving up on the play. And the smallest guy on the floor in navy blue comes away with the rebound. Battle in no man's land, and he traveled completely out of control. And that will bring Jude back into the ball game for the Bulldogs. He'll replace Lawson. Godwin receives the inbound pass. Warren, top of the key. Warren to the bucket. Layup is good. Got back to a two-point ball game here as Warren is finding so many different ways to get to the basket right now. Judd wide open for three. Hand down, man down. And Dejor Dickens forgot that the big man was a three-point threat. He makes the Pirates pay. Cody Jude with at least his second three. And that becomes the media timeout. So,
PJs.
Stay in the driver's seat with Domino's Carside Delivery.
Back here on ESPN Plus, where Davion Warren has been masterful, Joe, in helping to lead this charge to bring his team back into the ball game. But at the same time, UNC Asheville not going away quietly. Dude knocks down a big three to push it to the five-point advantage that UNC Asheville holds right now with 7.5 minutes to go.
Davion's trying to do his best Superman impression and put his cape on and come save the day, but UNC Asheville might have proven to be too much early on for them. We'll see as we get down to the stretch as Godwin lays it up for two.
Godwin's layup gives him 20. Warren with 24. Those are the only two Pirates in double figures. Asheville, why is it going to slow things down? Leading by three and run their offense. Bats in the lane, going to throw up a wild shot. It comes back to Battle. Battle is fouled on the ground. It looks like it's going to be on Deuce Dean. If it is, that's his fourth.
Deuce is being aggressive. He just got to be smart when he's being aggressive.
Hampton foul number one, Deuce Dean is fourth.
I understand trying to make a play for your team, but
that's his fourth and the fifth team foul. So
too important to exit the game because he's been fouling too much.
Dejor Dickens will replace Dean. Jones receives it inbounds. 18 seconds on the shot clock. Hampton shooting 50% from the floor. Asheville 43.6. Stephanie looking to create in the lane. Kick out. Jones pump fake. Jumper is short. Rebound Warren. Warren's got Danny Bannister ahead. He's going to go. Marquise. Three-pointer left wing for the tie. In and out. No good. Warren offensive rebound. His putback is good.
Davion Warren doing it once again.
It's a one-point ball game. Jude, again, three. Air ball. Long rebound comes back to him. Jones thought about it, but wisely will reset the offense. Bat's going to throw up a wild shot. No good. Chris Shelton will secure the rebound.
You know what I like? The Pirates are doing right now, they're not going for that pump fake that they fell for several times in the first half.
Warren throws it to Dickens. Dickens layup up and good.
Nice find by Warren.
Bulldogs brought the double. Warren able to find the open man. Stephanie driving, forces it, layup no good, tip to Godwin. And Hampton with the lead is going to slow things down, leading by one. Warren fights off the double screen, goes to the bucket, and they're going to call an offensive foul. Tough call, as it looked like Bannister went around the defender. It's a tough call for Danny Bannister, but Pirates lead by one and will fall back on defense.
If Bannister would have been dribbling with his head up, he would have saw he had Dickens right under the goal. Wide open dunk.
Stephanie will cross the timeline, finds Thorpe. Asheville letting time tick away here. Trailing by one, 5:13 to go. Thorpe goes downhill, attacks Bannister. Kick out, Stephanie will spot up from three. His shot is an air ball, and it will come down in the hands of the Pirates.
Looks like UNC Asheville has lost the steam that they had in the first half.
Warren took an ill-advised three, rebound to the Bulldogs. Under five to play. Stephanie in transition, goes to Jude. Jude took some steps, no call. Thorpe in the lane, in traffic, and he draws contact. Foul will be charged to Dejor Dickens. That'll be his third. 17 foul on Hampton. So Thorpe will go back to the free throw line.
He got fouled a few times on that drive.
Thorpe, first shot is good.
Tie ball game.
5 of 6 today he is from the free throw line as Claiborne will return to the floor. Second shot is good.
Asheville, UNC Asheville back with the 1-point lead.
Warren running the point with Deuce Dean on the bench. We'll look to create here with Dejor Dickens. Goes all the way to the bucket, and the layup is good. Teams exchanging the lead here. Hampton's lead is one. Under 4.5 to go. Thorpe. Pull up in the lane. Goes back to Claiborne. Claiborne triple teamed. Looks to create room and Dejor Dickens with the block. Tough defensive stand there for Hampton.
The length is starting to affect Claiborne now. Earlier he was putting bodies on people, but the second half he can't really do much of anything.
Warren short on the layup. Out let to Stephanie. Fast break. Stephanie inside out. Thorpe spot up left corner. His three. Good. L.J. Thorpe knocks down the three to put the Bulldogs back up by two. Warren looks for the screen. Gets to the cup. Left-hand layup is good, and the Asheville defense looks perplexed.
The stop-and-go game is impeccable.
Everyone looking at each other saying, I thought that was you. Jones, three, no good. Chris Shelton secures the rebound, and we're all tied at 69 as we approach 3 minutes here in Hampton. Bannister to the bucket, goes with the right hand, and the layup is good. Danny Bannister puts Hampton back on top by two as we're now under 3 minutes. Good find by Davion Warren.
Davion's doing it all right now. 30 points.
Thorpe goes up top, finds Battle. Battle dumps it off Claiborne, back up top, another three. Thorpe, can he go for two? No. Rebound comes to guess who? Davion Warren, who's Mr. Everything right now.
Man, he's got his double-double secured. He's only five assists shy of a triple-double. Let's see if he might be able to get that today. What do you think, Matt?
It's going to be tough with the much time left, but the way the defense is playing him, Godwin, step back. This three, short, almost rolled in. Rebound control by Asheville. Claiborne looks like he might have gotten poked in the eye. Thorpe nearly loses it out of bounds as we near the two-minute mark. Stephanie drops it off. Battle. Battle spinning. Layup is good. Tall square at 71 with under 2 minutes to go. Jude, Bats, and Warren and Deuce Dean all set to check in for their respective programs as a timeout call. It's going to be a full timeout. No one needs that timeout more than Davion Warren, who the last few times down the floor, Joe, was just had his hands on his knees trying to find some way to carry his team through here. It's Raw Square at 71.
He's trying to will his team to the finish line, will them to the promised land, and he's been doing it. He's got
Kleenex Ultra Soft Tissues, made for extra comfort, three layers strong. Kleenex, for all the moments.
Be at Charleston Southern at 6 o'clock, Campbell at Longwood, and that will be your slate of Big South men's basketball games here on this Saturday. Take another look here. Warren able to find Dickens wide open as he was double teamed for the lay-in. And then on this drive, Warren just using the hands, the feet, and the magic to get to the cup. And I believe this is the last one. Asheville expected the pass to go to Dickens. This time it was to the cutting Bannister. And a very important possession here for Hampton. Square at 71 with 1:45 to go. Pirates want to try and get the momentum and the advantage again here on the scoreboard. Warren nearly had his pocket picked, and he ends up throwing it out of bounds in an effort to get it to Shelton. And good defense there from the Bulldogs. I think it was Bats that was able to get his hand on it and break up the play.
Yeah, Asheville's been giving the Pirates fits all game defensively.
94 seconds left in this ball game. Who will make the least amount of mental mistakes and who will execute? Thorpe in the lane. Crossover. Layup. Shot is blocked. Asheville thought that might have been a goaltend. They were complaining initially, but Dejor Dickens.
That was a perfect block. That 7 foot is coming in handy right now.
So far, both teams have had a possession, and both teams have made defensive stops. Deuce Dean back on the floor. Bass is playing off. Dean, floater in the lane. Back iron, no good. No one in position to rebound for Hampton, and we're under 1 minute to go here in the Convocation Center. And Bats will call the timeout with 54.1 seconds remaining. The tough shooting woes continue for Deuce Dean. I don't think he realized just how open he was going to be right there and kind of force it up late. He's 1 of 8 from the floor.
As we take a look at that beautiful block by Dickens, I don't think anybody thought he was going to be as effective in the block game this late down the game. But, I mean, I believe he leads the Big South in blocks with just under three per game.
We have Pirates lead the conference in several keys categories, as you mentioned, blocks. At one point, Davion led the conference in steals. I know he's still going into today's game, he was still leading the conference in points at 19.3. So today's effort will definitely help that average.
And you know, he solidified that with 30 today.
Deuce Dean second in the conference in assists at 6.9. Yeah, Davion still leads the conference in steals, averaging 2.2 a game. Chris Shelton actually is your three-point field goal percentage leader in the conference at 48.6. Right behind him is, guess who, Mr. Jones for UNC Asheville at 42%.
Mr. Jones.
And we will resume action here, 71 all, 50 seconds and counting. Bats guarded by Godwin, Pirates showing man-to-man. Claiborne looks to set the screen. They split the defenders. Shot blocked by Davion Warren, and Asheville can't believe it.
Claiborne has been doing it big all game and just can't get to the rim down the stretch right now, man. He's getting blocked all over the place.
And the chess match continues. It'll be a full timeout called by Hampton. Again, Coach Morrell livid. He was looking for the foul call, as you have to give Asheville credit. Bats dropped a dime in the breadbasket between two defenders. Claiborne made the amazing catch, and Davion Warren, or
it looked like a combined effort.
Yeah, it might have been Davion and Dickens. Of course, Dickens was coming from the weak side, as on the screen and roll, DeJour came off of Claiborne. But take another look at it here. You see that beautiful pass, and it looks like that was Warren that was able to just get his hand up and jar it loose.
That was a diamond all ball block.
Yeah, there was no body contact there, so credit the official with the no call.
Wow. Man.
So 28.9 seconds left in the game, 22 seconds showing on the shot clock.
I can only imagine what Claiborne's thinking right now. He's like, man, I've had open dunks. I've been bodying folks all day down in the paint, and now I can't get anything to drop. They're taking his confidence away. Got to get that confidence back.
So let's see how the Pirates work the clock here. If they work this shot clock, Asheville will have just a tenth of a second under seven full seconds left for, you know, a look, which in basketball can be an eternity.
Mm-hmm.
But let's see here. All square 71, 28.9 seconds. Deuce Dean to inbound.
I want to see how Asheville covers Warren.
It's deflected. Will remain Hampton ball at 28.5. 22 seconds showing on the shot clock. Pirates inbound again. They get it to Warren. Bats will back away. Warren, and we got a foul. Good foul by Asheville, just their fourth team foul. So three more fouls before Pirates are looking at free throws. But the issue, though, with that, when you foul, you're potentially milking the clock for Hampton as well, because now it's only going to be about a four-second difference between the game clock and the shot clock. Another foul.
Well, here's the thing. UNC Asheville knows that they have been...
So now the shot clock, not to cut you off, now the shot clock is turned off.
Yeah, UNC Asheville knows that they've been making it hard for the Pirates to get the ball inbound. So what they're banking on, I think, is that they make it hard for the Pirates to get the ball in and create a turnover somehow. That's the only thing I can think of right now.
Well, you better hope it works out like that. Otherwise, you've eliminated. You're now giving the Pirates the opportunity to hold for the last shot. 8 seconds left. Davion. It's going to attack the basket here. 3-2, driving. The shot's up. Oh, and a foul is called on the drive.
Wow.
This is exactly why I said you don't do those fouls.
Wow.
Because now Davion hits one or both. There's only 1 second left on the shot clock.
Hey, man, I can only tell you what I think the coach was thinking.
Yeah, no. And I agree that's what you're thinking. I'm just telling you why that's not a great strategy.
It's terrible.
Because if you don't foul, you get the ball back hypothetically with just under 7 seconds left.
Yeah, that's a terrible strategy.
First free throw from Warren is good.
Wow. Man.
So I'm not sure what the timeout situation is.
Uh-oh.
Asheville, hypothetically, if with the timeout, could advance here with the timeout to a half court. Second free throw is up, and it's good. Asheville has to throw it in. 1 second. The half court heave is up. It is no good, and that is the ball game. 73-71. Hampton.
What a game.
They comes back. Coach Morrell stares the officials as they walk off the floor. Davion Warren with 32 is Superman.
Good game,
and carries us to the victory here in Hampton as Hampton comes away. 73-71, 32 points for Davion Warren. 14 of 25 shooting. Marquise Godwin with 20 points on 46.7% shooting. The two Pirates, the only Pirates in double figures as Warren gets to the bucket there. As we take a look at the final stats for Asheville, Jones with 17, Thorpe with 15, Claiborne with 12, and Jude with 10. Again, tomorrow we'll be back. Same two teams, 1 o'clock tip here at the Convocation Center on ESPN+. Thank you. Have a safe evening, and we'll be back with you tomorrow.